So now let's talk about another important part of the CV, which is research. Many people, when they apply to residency, they get like so overwhelmed by research, saying that, oh, I don't have any publications, or like how many publications should I have? And like, in my opinion, like, yes, having publications, of course, will add extra to your CV, but it's not the end of the world if you don't have any publications. If you only have the experience without a publication, that is also enough sometimes. Because like research is a different beast. I could, like, literally, it took me 3 years of doing my, like, during my residency to do lots of research to understand the research process. Writing a paper, data extraction, data collection, submitting an IRB. So it's really tough process. So if you don't have publications, don't get overwhelmed. If you have an experience, you still can mention it, right? So that's why I mentioned two tables here, or like I wrote two tables here. So people can talk about their research. If you have only experience, let's say you assisted in a project and the project is still in the infant phase and it's not released yet, it's not published yet. So you can write it in this form. If you have lots of publications, okay, and you have some posters and you have some abstracts, so you can divide them into three sections like this table. This will make it easier to the reader to understand, like, if you have like full manuscripts, if you have abstracts, and how many like poster presentations you have. Okay, so when it comes to the research experience, of course, as usual, consistency, 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 the title of the research project, your title. Usually this is not very applicable to medical students. I've seen cases where medical students are like principal investigators or co-investigators, but most of the time medical students are helping with other projects, because like you need to understand the ins and outs of a discipline and what is lacking in the literature to go and create a research project directed toward that part. So you can skip this. Of course, if you're an international medical graduate with master's or PhD and you have like you are a principal investigator in a big study, you can mention it, your title. And if the study was supported by an institution, if you get funding, or who is your supervisor, and the name of the institution, the city and the country and the year. Usually it's better to mention the year here just for consistency. And the authors. When you mention the authors, it's very important to bold or underline your name. It's up to you. Both are like can work, just to show where do you stand. Usually being the first author is very impactful. The last author is the person who supervised the entire project. So this is very rare to see. But again, people with master's or PhD might have projects where they are the last authors. So, and then if you want to add something, like let's say you have only research experience and you want to highlight the things that you helped or you participated in, so what was your role? Highlight that. So what is the study? The study aims to determine what did you do? Did you do a literature review? Did you assist with data extraction from charts or from manuscripts? Did you interview patients and ask them questions, and you did a qualitative paper? Did you obtain institutional review board approval, IRB approval? Did you help in writing the manuscript? So what was your role? If you are going to mention research experience, even you can mention your role under poster presentation or publication or abstract. This is completely up to you. If you want to highlight, let's say under publication, you help from A to Z. You help in the IRB approval, you help with writing the manuscript. So you can add that to add more validity to your experience, okay? And then if you did poster presentation, it applies the same, but where was the poster presentation? Where, like which conference? So it's nice to add the conference. And did you receive any award for the poster presentation? The same applies for the abstract, the same applies for the publications. Also for the publications, one thing you can add is the DOI number. Every publication has its own specific number on PubMed. You can add that, or you can add a link to your publication. So the reader can, when they are going through your CV, can click on that or can search your publication through your DOI. And very important, very important, very important, very important, before your interviews, read your CV very well. It's the worst situation when a program director or someone who's interviewing you asks you, oh, tell me about that research project, what was your role? And you just stop and you can't answer that question. So it's really important to understand what was your role and to, because like some people, like let's say if I did like a research project 4 years ago and I really can't remember what was my role, that's really not a good sign. Because like sometimes you're, if one of your friends is doing the research and drop your name there and you have an extra publication, and then like the interviewer asks you, oh, like tell me about this research project. I read the paper and I really liked it. So what was your role? And you can't talk about your role. So that's not a good situation. So read your research, make sure you know the ins and outs of every project because you might get asked about your role and your experience in that research project. Okay, to summarize, if you have only research experience without publications, don't be afraid to mention it, okay? If you have publications, it's nicer for the reader to like summarize, to put them on their poster presentation, abstracts for or full publication, depends on what you have. And make sure to know your role and what did you do in every project, each one of them.